today, this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to escape a haunted mansion, because obviously I know. Okay, so this is 10 tips to try and stay alive or try and escape the haunted mansion. Just the one. I mean, others may vary. Okay, so tip number one goes out to all horror movies and all horror games. There is no need to explore the basement or the attic. Are you mad? Something calls itself a haunted mansion, yet they still need to keep things hidden? That is none of your business, okay? And very much a way to get yourself murdered instantly. So tip number one is to stay away from dark, monster-infested places. Ever, actually. Okay, so tip number two is to get a torch. Although the ghosts like to do the torch flicky thing. Yeah, they like to do that for fun. Always, in every single thing I've ever seen, the torch flickers. So, be prepared for this to happen. And it's also a good thing not to freak out at the first hurdle. Show them you are not afraid. Another good thing for a torch is to see where it's dark. And it's always dark in a haunted mansion, so... Tip number three, wear a crash helmet. So I have thought this one through. Ghosts are made of sort of air. They don't really have a body. So what they do enjoy doing is throwing things at people. So if you're wearing a crash helmet, you're less likely to fall unconscious. And you don't want to be knocked unconscious whilst you have ghouls fiddling around with your pleasant self. Tip number four, now you are equipped, get out. It's unfortunate that you will naturally have to travel through several areas before finding the door. Okay, so right now, get out of the room that you are in and try to stay quick. There is no time for dilly-dallying. You need to get out of there as fast as you possibly can. Just because then the ghost might not catch you and drag your soul out through your chest. It's good to be quick anyway. Your mum will be worried. Also, the walls might have arms, so... Tip number five, look out of the window. Quickly though, don't film like a time lapse or anything. See how high you are from the ground, because then you know how to reach the lower level where the door is. Now I'm not saying jump unless you're only like one or two floors up and there's a conveniently placed bush underneath you, but I mean, if you jump you're more or less likely to leave with your soul, but then you might not leave with your bones. And then proceed to the lower ground. Tip number six. Headphones! Noises are the scariest part of the haunted house. All the ooh and, like, you know, terrible screaming. Some sort of banshee in the side. You know, all of that sort of adds to the effect of the haunted mansion. So, if you drown out that, you're more or less likely to not be as scared. Just be oblivious to the unknown. I would recommend some theme tunes. Perhaps Indiana Jones, Mission Impossible. Or a good one might be Ghostbusters. Okay, so the next four tips are going to be showing you the different rooms that you might need to escape before eventually reaching the door. Okay, so number seven is you might wander into a kitchen. The first thing I would recommend doing is picking up any sort of baking trays or sort of, you know, metal sort of shields. You know, the ghosts are keen bakers. The ghosts might be angry at this point because they haven't killed you yet, and they might be a bit disappointed that you are not one of them. Is that what they want? They want to make you one of them? I don't know, I'm presuming that they might be chasing after you, perhaps whizzing around your head, flashing up and then disappearing. Those sort of things, you know. So if you're in a kitchen, the thing they're probably going to be throwing at you is knives or any sort of sharp implements. Perhaps one of those corn holders, maybe. Hence the shields! Another just sneaky tip on the side, don't bother shutting doors. Why is it on all these games that you can shut the door and apparently the ghosts can't get to you? They're ghosts! They don't do doors! Number eight is how to escape the library. There is always a library in a haunted house, stacked full of books. Normally in these places they have a lit fire, maybe with a nice old armchair, probably facing backwards towards you. This is probably where the demon thing is going to be sitting. Don't go and check it out. It's probably going to jump scare you and feast on your dreams. You know that, really. But whilst you're there, you may as well pick up a few books. I mean, they'll probably be old, so they might be worth something on eBay. Tip nine, you're probably in the last room now, which might be the living room. This might have a TV on it that flashes up with different messages, saying something like, "We will kill you, Martin," or whatever your name is. The only ghost ghosts I want on my TV are Pac-Man ghosts, so get the hell out of there! Because it's very near the exit, the ghosts want you to stay in there, so they probably locked the door. When this happens, retreat to the bathroom. This has probably been there thousands of years, it probably smells a bit. On the walls, they'll probably have written in blood, "You will never leave." But they are wrong, Martin, because you are gonna get out. Who's Martin? Because you're gonna get out of there, and this is how you do it. You just basically rip the shower curtain down, put it over your head as a disguise, and then you go to the door and you'll be like, "No, I'm one of you," and then they'll open the door for you, and then you just sort of be on your way. That would probably work if you hadn't have died already. And that's great, because now you get to live in a mansion. And that's a good thing. That's how you escape. You don't. Okay, so that's the end of the video. I hope you liked it. Please subscribe for more videos like this every single day. I also did a video called How to Escape a Zombie Apocalypse. I'll leave that in the description below if you do, you know, need to use that one. Okay, so I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, bye. Tip 9 is if you... 9?